CBSE Class 10 Math Year 2020 Sample Paper, Standard Version, 2-mark question, question number 23. This question has got two alternatives. Both the alternatives tested concepts from triangles. Alternative 1 focused on similar triangles. Alternative 2 focused on equilateral triangles and congruent triangles. We have solutions to both the alternatives in this video. Let's get started with the first one. In the given figure, DEFG is a square. So this shaded portion is a square. And angle BAC is equal to 90 degrees. It's a right angle. What we need to prove is this expression, FG square equals BG times FC. Let's come to that in a minute. Here's the diagram that we have. We know DEFG is a square. In a square, all four sides are equal. Let's assign a variable for the sides. Let's say each of the sides, let it measure A units. So because it's a square, DE equals EF equals FG equals GD. Angle BAC is a right angle that's equal to 90 degrees. I'm going to assign one variable. Let's say angle ABC in this triangle, let it be equal to theta. Sum of the interior angles of a triangle equals 180 degrees. So a 90 plus sum of these two angles equals 180. So sum of these two angles alone, angle ABC plus angle ACB will be equal to 90 degrees because this is a right angle, which means angle ACB will be equal to 90 minus theta. Quickly summarize this till this point. Sum of the three interior angles is equal to 180. We have assigned angle ABC to be equal to a theta. So solving for it, we get angle BCA or angle ACB, whichever way you look at it, to be equal to 90 minus theta. Now, we know that it's a square. DEFG is a square. All interior angles are equal to 90 degrees. All exterior angles are equal to 90 degrees. So we know that angle DGB and angle EFC are both right angles. In the last slide, we assigned these two variables, this as a theta, and therefore we computed this to be equal to a 90 minus theta. Let's focus on triangle DGB. It's a right triangle. One angle is 90, the second angle is theta. Therefore, the third angle, which is angle BDG, will be equal to 90 minus theta. Quickly summarize this bit in a printed form. We know that angle DGB is 90 because it's the exterior angle of the square. Angle DBG is nothing but angle ABC, which is equal to theta. Sum of the interior angles in triangle DBG or DGB is equal to 180. Therefore, we have found out the value of angle BDG to be equal to 90 minus theta. Quickly run through that with this second triangle, I'll call it as triangle 2. In this triangle, angle EFC is the exterior angle of the square, 90 degrees. Angle ACB or BCA is the same as angle ECF, which is 90 minus theta, which means the third angle, which is CEF or FEC, should be equal to theta. Quickly summarize that in a printed form. EFC is equal to 90. We know that BCA is 90 minus theta, which means ECF is also 90 minus theta. Sum of the interior angles is equal to 180. So angle FEC is equal to theta. I'll call this as triangle 1. I'm going to call this as triangle 2. Observe the angles in both the triangles 1 and 2. All three angles are equal. So by AA or AAA, we know that these two triangles are similar triangles. Triangle DGB is similar to, D is 90 minus theta. So I'll go with the C here, C. G is 90 degrees. So in this case, it is F. So DGB is similar to CFE. Let's write proportions of the sides. So that would make it as DG divided by CF, DG divided by CF is equal to GB divided by FB, GB divided by FE. Sides of the triangle, we assigned it a variable which is equal to A, so AAA. What is DG? One of the sides of the triangle, let that be equal to A. CF is this, so let's leave it as it is. So CF is the same as FC, you could probably spot what we are trying to prove. What is GB? GB we do not know, so let's keep it as it is. We have GB as BG here. The next one is FE. FE is another side of a triangle which is equal to A. So cross multiply, we'll get A square is equal to, I'll write the GB as a BG, GB equals BG, and the CF as an FC. So the right hand side of what we needed to prove is already there. Left hand side is A square. What is A? A is the side of the square. So it could be DG, it could be DE, it could be EF, it could also be FG. So instead of A square, we'll write it as FG. So FG square is equal to BG times FC. This is what we wanted to prove. We have proved it. Quickly summarize it in a printed form. We're establishing similarity using AAA. Triangle DGB is similar to triangle CFE. Writing proportions, DG by CF equals GB by EF. DG times, we're cross multiplying, EF is equal to BG times FC. So right hand side is done. DG equals EF is equal to FG. So we're replacing that. So we get FG square is equal to BG times FC. So part 1 done. Alternative 1 done, not part 1. Let's move on to alternative 2. Alternative 2, the same question. Focuses concepts on equilateral triangles and we'll be solving it using congruent concepts. In an equilateral triangle, prove that 3 times the square of one side is equal to 4 times the square of one of its altitude. It's a right triangle. The side of the right triangle be equal to A. Let AD be the altitude. Because it's an altitude, it's going to be at right angles to BC, the opposite side. So look at these two triangles, ADB and ADC. We have established that both these triangles are right angle triangles. The hypotenuse of triangle ADB is AB. Hypotenuse of triangle ADC is equal to AC. So the hypotenuse is the same for both these triangles. Both are right triangles, so R established. Both of these triangles are the same hypotenuse established. One of the perpendicular sides is the common side AD. So by RHS, we can establish that ADB and ADC are congruent triangles. If ADB and ADC are congruent triangles, the corresponding parts of congruent triangles, corresponding parts would be equal, which means BD should be equal to DC. If BD is equal to DC, then that is going to be equal to A by 2. BD is A by 2 and DC is equal to A by 2. We're going to apply Pythagoras theorem in triangle, right triangle ADB. Hypotenuse square, which is AB square, is equal to AD square plus BD square. What is AB? AB is equal to A square. AD square is what we're trying to actually find out the value as. This plus BD is equal to A by 2 the whole square. So we get the value of AD square to be equal to A square minus A square by 4, which is 3A square by 4. Cross multiply this. So we have 4 times AD square is equal to 3 times A square. What is A? A is the side. So 3 times the square of the side is equal to 4 times. What is AD? AD is the altitude. So 4 times the square of its altitude is equal to 3 times the square of its side, which is what we wanted to prove. So alternative 2 is also done. Alternative 2 is a wee bit more easier than alternative 1. So if I had to choose in the examination, I would have gone with alternative 2 than alternative 1. Before you leave, do 2 things. Sign up at online.maxtute.com for CBSE online coaching for class 10 maths. It takes less than 5 minutes in all of 3 steps to get started. And do 1 more thing. Subscribe to this channel, youtube.com/maxtute, and spread the word about this channel to your friends and classmates.